Just heard it, ladies and gentlemen. That is too far, two against, and one abstention, meaning that no action can be taken on the request and things will stay status quo. Ric Flair, at this point, is not re-entering.
It is with this in mind that he wishes all parties to be fair to Flair.
And the number one reason WCW should be fair to Flair is...
This is WCW Saturday Night, along with Bobby the Brain Heenan, and I'm Tony Schiavone. Hi, everyone. What a tremendous main event we have. Sting one-on-one against Stunning Steve later on in this program. But a lot of talk during the week about the WCW Executive Committee, about the deadlock vote. 2-4, two against Ric Flair, and one abstention. They could not get Ric Flair reinstated, but we understand Commissioner Nick Bockwinkle will be back with us with a statement based on what happened last week. Something is still up, fans. With Brain, Ric Flair is back with us by another segment of the program. Be fair to Ric Flair is what it's called.
I can change all that with my vote right here. I can vote the right way. Let me put in my vote, and then we have to worry about anything like that. You can keep Flair off as long as you want, Bockwinkle and Championship Committee. You can shove him in the back as long as you want. You can try to run and dodge, have these big, big highfalutin meetings where you don't answer the phones. But as long as Ric Flair has a dime in his pocket, as long as he's the man that walks that aisle, as long as he's the man that's done what he's done for this great sport, he can buy time on this program. And Bockwinkle, you and the likes of the people here at WCW cannot keep him off this program, period. Well, like it or not.
Well, that's exactly right. Like we said, we'll be going to the Nature Boy Ric Flair later in his segment that he has purchased on the program. And Sting and Stunning Steve one-on-one in the main event. Let's go to the ring, the first bout this week on WCW Saturday Night.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Morristown, Tennessee, weighing 214 pounds, White Lightning, Tim Horner.
All right, Tim Horner, opening up the telecast here on Saturday night. He's a fine young athlete there, Brain.
And he's from Tennessee.
And what's wrong with that?
Nothing. I didn't say anything wrong.
You like Bucksnort, don't you?
Well, Bucksnort's not even like Tennessee.
Yeah, I bet.
Different.
All right, let's go back to Gary Capetta, the introduction of the next opponent on Saturday night. Oh.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Cobb County, Georgia, weighing 337 pounds, Big Bubba Rogers.
Here is one lethal guy, Brain, Big Bubba, maybe one of the most impressive men over the past couple of weeks in our sport we've ever seen.
Well, Tim Horner's going to find out what this big man's all about real quick. He takes off his coat and his tie and his hat and glasses. He's come to work. Mr. Horner, you just ordered yourself a butt kicking.
Man, still to come, we will see for the first time ever Lord Steven Regal and Beatable Bobby in the ring. We'll take a look at Beatable Bobby and what happened recently when he met the Queen of England. And he was dubbed Earl Robert.
Sir Robert of Eton.
No, it's Earl Robert.
Earl Robert of Eton.
Yes.
I'm Sir Robert. Excuse me.
Yeah, don't. You shouldn't mix yourself up with Beatable Bobby. Oh, moving down the way, Tim Horner. And a roll up, one, two, got a two count. Plus, we'll hear from Commissioner Nick Bockwinkle about Ric Flair. Still in this telecast, big drop kick. Bubba goes down hard, hit the ropes. That's the only thing that kept him on his feet, Brain.
It's hard to keep him down. He's such a big, big man. Horner's giving it a fight, but Bubba's just too big.
White Lightning, Tim Horner, and Bubba's got him. Oh, my. Head first to the top turnbuckle.
Do they call him White Lightning because he's so fast in that ring?
That's what they...
Because he drinks out of that big jug.
No. And now Bubba stepping on the throat and the head of Tim Horner.
Mr. Horner, does the word revenuers mean anything to you?
Wait a second. Well, he pushes the referee away.
That'll cost him some money.
Wait a minute. Here comes Brad Armstrong. Tim Horner's longtime partner. And he gets rid of Big Bubba.
What is he doing in the ring? He's got no business there. You know that.
He was trying to hurt
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match as a result
a disqualification. Big Bubba Rogers.
All right, well, Brad Armstrong got in his face, and he's had enough of what Big Bubba's done to his partner, Tim Horner. He was trying to hurt that young man right here on our opening bout on Saturday night.
Well, that young man, Tim Horner, has a reputation. He's a tough guy, too. He knows what it's like in that ring. If Brad Armstrong don't understand, it's not my fault.
All right, I'm going to go over here and talk to Brad about what happened. Let's see if we can get him over here. Let's get our floor director here.
Well, Brad's making his way over to Tony right now.
All right, Brad Armstrong has made his way over here. And, Brad, I know you got a lot on your mind, especially after what you've seen in the ring.
You know, Tim Horner's like family to me. I don't know what happened to this Big Bubba Rogers, but, brother, his head's turned all the way around. He's looking the wrong direction, I can tell you right now. I tell you what, Bubba Rogers, you're not the only one here from Cobb County, Georgia, fella. I was born and raised in Cobb County, Georgia, too. I came from a fighting family, and no, I ain't the biggest, and no, I ain't the baddest. But, brother, I can walk with the baddest every day of the week. And tomorrow night, if you accept my challenge right here, I'll be right here tomorrow night, buddy, on the main event, and you see if you can come get you some of this Cobb County boy. He's running around beating people up like a man possessed. Well, I may repossess you tomorrow night on the main event, brother. You can take that to the bank.
All right, Brad Armstrong and fans, we'll have more on Saturday night right after this.
Ah, Colonel Parker and Stunning Steve, the Stinger is going to take the stunning out of both of you. Woo!